Hey, it's Professor Hendricks, and today I'd like to talk about the Biopython SeqIO module. So the SeqIO module can be accessed from Biopython, and this is a documentation page that's describing the module's contents, and it's quite a lot of stuff here. But what I first want to show you is how to read a FASTA file using SeqIO, and later on in the next video I'll show you how to read FASTQ files. So first thing we want to do is we want to download a FASTA file. I'm going to show you this particular one from GenCode. So GenCode is a consortium that curates data on transcripts and genes. And I'm looking at the human data of the human transcriptome. And I'm going to scroll down to this FASTA file section. And there's a protein coding transcript. So I'm going to go to this FASTA download. And rather than download directly, I'm going to right click and copy link address. And I'm going to go to the servers. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a directory for GenCode, just for this example, and cd into GenCode. And I'm going to download this file from the web directly with wget. And it just takes a few seconds to download this file. And what ends up happening is the file is downloaded as a gzipped file. And it is a gzipped file, so it's a gzipped FASTA file. So this is kind of like just a way of zipping files, but it's part of the GNU system. And so what all I need to do is just unzip this with gunzip. And so that's gunzip or gunzip, GenCode. And I just auto-complete the file name with tab there, hit enter, and it should be able to unzip it in a few seconds, and ls, and there's the file. So I can view this file with less. And I can see that there are multiple lines per sequence record, and I have a pretty detailed def line for each record here. And this def line, interestingly enough, encodes information about the UTR, the 5' UTR, the CDS or coding sequence, and the 3' UTR. And so, for example, I think there are 60 characters per line, and I can confirm that in this first example just coincidentally happens to have a UTR from 1 to 60. And I can see that the next line starts with that ATG, that start codon of the CDS sequence. So these positions are actually defined in one-based inclusive positions, and that's different from the way Python defines substrings. So we'll need to modify accordingly when we read this file in. So let's see what happens if we read the file in. First thing I want to do is I want to copy the file name for later, and so I'll copy that. And I'm just going to do this all in the Python terminal, just for simplicity. I'm going to clear my screen with Control-L. But I'm still in the Python terminal because I got these three greater than signs. So first thing I would need to do is import the module. And so for that, we just want to say from bio import SeqIO. And so SeqIO, that's a capital I, capital O, the letter O, not the number zero. And that just stands for input output. So this is basically a module that has a lot of tools for reading and writing files. And so if we were to first read that particular FASTA file, I'm going to define a variable called sequences that's going to store the output, and it's going to be seqio.parse. Now, seqio.parse takes in two arguments. It takes in a file name and a file format. I can actually just paste the file name directly here, or if you like, I can define a, I can basically start over and define a file name as a variable, and I guess I'll just do that for fun here. So I'm going to define file name, and I'll put in quotes my file name. So now I have a dedicated variable for that file name, and then I'll say sequences equals seqio.parse. And again, I need two things, the file name, which is just the variable file name now, and then a file format. And that needs to be in quotes, and that's going to be FASTA here because we're reading a FASTA file. But this could take on other forms, other file formats that may be valid. Okay, so now at this point, we've established a connection between the file system and our Python code. We haven't actually read the entire file yet. We haven't loaded it into memory. We've just sort of established a connection and maybe in some sense opened a file handle to that file. But SeqIO parse is more than just a file handle creator. It has other tools for parsing a specific file format and understanding that file format. So to illustrate that, what I'd like to do is loop through the file loop through the records in this file, and I'm going to break on the first one just for illustration. So I would do something like this. I would say for. maybe what I'll do is I'll define a variable called example, and I will define that for the first record. So I'd say for record in sequences, colon, and hit enter, and then I need the tab to be defined as part of my for loop. And so check out my video on for loops and iterable objects for for loops in general. But suffice to say that sequences is an iterable object. It doesn't contain the sequences yet, but it's an iterable object that allows me to loop through all the records of the file in a systematic way. And so I'm going to store the first record as the variable called example. And then I'm going to break. Break is a special keyword in Python that exits the innermost for loop, in this case, the only for loop, which is this for record in sequences. At this point, we should have stored that example. And so I can print example and I can see the contents here. And let me print, if I print example this way, what do we get? So now it prints a series of attributes of this particular object. And so we see it has an ID, it has a name, it has a description. All these seem to store pretty much the same information. And then it also has the seq itself. It actually has a seq object associated with it. So let's see, what is the type, the data type of this particular record that we stored? It is a bio.seqrecord.seqrecord. So commonly known as the seq record class or seq record object in this case. This is a seq record object, you could say. And we could access various features or attributes. So we could say example.id, and that gets the contents of this ID record here. We could say example.seq, and that stores a seq object. And so example.seq has all the functionality of a ordinary seq object that we might have defined in the Python terminal directly. But this was read in from a file, so we can do a lot more with that. And so in this particular example, it has a CDS coding DNA sequence. And so some people call the CDS coding sequence, but with, you know, the capital letter on the D, I like saying coding DNA sequence. It makes a little more sense because it originated from DNA. At this point, it's sort of, we're dealing with a transcript annotation technically. So that's basically, it's basically an RNA, but, you know, it kind of still makes sense. So it's sort of a way of thinking about that acronym. This is from 61 to 1041 in one-based inclusive coordinates. So we need to convert that to Pythonic zero-based non-inclusive end position. So I'm going to define ORF as a new seq object that's going to store, or actually I can call it CDS. And so this is going to store the CDS, and so I need to do example.seq, and then I would put the brackets. So I can treat example.seq just as I would treat seq object called DNA. I would do the exact same thing. I'd put the square brackets. So check my video on seq objects if this seems surprising. And I would need to put the start positions. So I put start colon end. And so the start is going to be the zero base start. So if the one base start is 61, the zero base start is one less than that, so 60. So I put 60. And then for the end, okay, so this is kind of funny. So actually the best way to do it is to do 1041 directly, the one-based stop position, the one-based end position, because I could subtract 1 from 141 to convert to zero-based, but I'd have to add the 1 back because Pythonic substrings don't include the end. So I have to add 1 more than the end. So it basically amounts to the same thing. It amounts to just using the one-based index there. So if I do this, and so define CDS, and so I can print CDS like so, and I get the entire contents of this sequence. And so I can confirm that it does begin with an ETG and ends with a stop codon, TAG. So everything tracks here. And so I can also translate this directly. I can do CDS.translate, and I get the entire protein sequence. It's going to be truncated if you print out the seq object, but I can do something like print of CDS.translate. And that'll print the entire sequence along with an asterisk at the end for the stop codon. So now I want to show you something. So I'm going to quit here and I'm going to ask how many transcript sequences are in this file? And one way to do that is to use grep. Now, word of caution, if you're going to grep for a greater than sign, you want to use quotes around the greater than sign. Let me show you what I mean. Every one of these defline records has a greater than sign as defined by the FASTA format, and if you're new to FASTA files, please check out my video on reading FASTA files using basic Python to get a sense of how you would approach it that way, but it also talks about this, the basic concept of a FASTA file. So this defline entry for each record, it's one line, it begins with a greater than sign, and immediately after we have a unique identifier for the sequence. And so if we grep on greater than signs, what that does is it prints out all the lines that have a greater than sign. But again, you want to use quotes around the greater than sign because you could risk overwriting the file. And in fact, you probably will overwrite the contents of the file if you don't have the quotes around the greater than sign. So that's very important. So if I hit enter here, it just basically dumps to the screen a bunch of def lines, and I can type control C. By the way, control C is an all-purpose exit. If you ever get stuck in GNU Linux, you can do control C to exit that. And so what I want to do is I want to not just dump these to the screen, but I want to pipe them into word count, and word count will tell me how many lines in the file. So I have 103,155 transcripts in this file, and so that's basically an annotation of the human transcriptome being 103,000 distinct transcripts. Probably no one really knows how many transcripts are in the human transcriptome, but this is an annotation or a model of what is in there. New transcripts are discovered all the time, new splice variants, new isoforms, new non-coding RNAs. So it's really almost, it's near impossible to say precisely how many transcripts are in the human transcriptome, but this is probably a decent estimate. So what I wanted to do is I wanted to loop through the entire contents of that file, append each record to a list, and then make sure that it has the same number as expected, this 103,155 number. So what I want to do is I want to define my file name again. And so that's going to be this GenCode file. So I just simply copy and paste that just like I did before. And I want to import, I want to do from bio import SeqIO to get that SeqIO module. And then I want to define a list, and I'll just call it L with square brackets. And so that's going to be my list. I'm going to append records to that list and see how many there are. And so I would do for record. Well, I guess I need to open sequences first. So I'll do sequences equals seqio.parse of the file name and the FASTA. And so now I've got this, but if I print sequences, it's not going to print a bunch of sequences. It's going to tell me, hey, this is a generator object. This is sort of this abstract Python object that allows me to iterate over all the sequences, but does not yet contain the sequences. It's probably a file handle and maybe some other information that might be useful specifically for FASTA files. So what I would do is I would say for record in sequences, actually loop through those sequences, and I can do l.append to append to this list. And it takes just a few seconds to loop through all those 100,000 transcripts, and it is done. And so now I can check, I can do len of l, and so I expect that to be this precise number, 103,155. Hit enter, and lo and behold, it is exactly right. So if I confirm the type of L, now L is just a list. It's just an ordinary Python list. I didn't make anything special here. But if I access these individual records, these individual terms of my list are these seek record objects. And so if I did type of say for example, L of 2, I get that it's a bio.seekrecord.seekrecord. And I can actually access information. So for example, if I said L2.seek, I would get the seek object that's linked to that seek record object, and I can access information from that as needed. So with that, I hope that gives you a brief introduction to parsing FASTA files with SeqIO module, and I'll see you next time.